The number of workers continues to decline in the manufacturing industry, and even more are expected with the upcoming restructuring of mainstay industries, including shipbuilding. As a countermeasure to the rising unemployment rate and to expand social safety nets, many have called for the enhancement of Korea's unemployment benefits, which is currently below the OECD average. On the other hand, there are also concerns that better benefits may diminish the recipients' job-seeking activities, which will in turn have a negative impact on employment. Accordingly, using an overlapping generation model, the study examines the overall effects of enhanced unemployment benefits on macroeconomic conditions, including employment, consumption, and social welfare, among others, and draws on the policy implications. Two much-discussed simulations were conducted to analyze the changes in social welfare. The first assumed 10% point increase in the wage replacement rate, and the second a one-month extension of the maximum duration of benefits. The first simulation reveals that if the wage replacement rate increases 10% point from the current 50% to 60%, approximately 20% of all recipients, that is, all those not subject to the lower benefit limit, and a small number of those who are and receive 90% of the minimum wage, will be affected. In this case, the positive impact of the increase in the average consumption of recipients is outweighed by the negative impact of a falling employment rate and a rising insurance rate, and as a result, social welfare is reduced overall. Meanwhile, a one-month extension of the benefit duration will affect all recipients. And the negative impact will be relatively large as the average consumption of recipients, mainly those subject to the lower limit, and the overall employment rate falls and insurance premiums rise. However, despite the fall in average consumption, the consumption of asset-lacking, vulnerable groups will increase and will therefore offset the negative impact and have a much greater positive impact on social welfare.
모의실험 결과, 현재의 실업급여 제도와 수급자 분포화에서는 임금 대체율을 높이는 것보다는 최대 지급 기간을 늘리는 것이 사회후생 측면에서 보다 적합한 것으로 나타났습니다. 이러한 실험 결과는 향후 상대적으로 취약계층 수급자의 혜택을 늘리는 방식으로 실업급여의 보장성을 강화할 필요가 있음을 시사합니다. 다만 보장성 강화는 고용보험료 인상을 요구하기 때문에 고용보험 가입 근로자와 기업의 부담을 감안하여 점진적으로 보장성을 늘려야 할 것입니다. 그리고 고용에 미치는 부작용을 최소화하기 위해 실업급여 제도에서 구직활동 확인과 재취업 지원 기능도 내실화할 필요가 있습니다.